In this problem, we're studying a heavy disk that's accelerated from rest by a string wrapped around a small hub that's glued on the center. And we're given the specs on the disk. It's 3.5 kilograms. It has a radius of 40 centimeters. And we're told that we apply a constant force by pulling on that string. So that's a constant force of 25 newtons. We're also told how much string we pull out during the process. That's 1.2 meters. And how long it takes. That's 1.5 seconds. So in part A, we're going to find the work done as we pull that string out. In part B, we'll use the work energy theorem to get the final angular velocity of the disk. In part C, we compute the angular acceleration of this disk. And then part D is a really unusual question. We actually have everything we need to compute the radius of that small hub at the center. So the work calculation is simple enough because our force is pulling exactly parallel to the displacement as we pull this string out. So our work is just going to be that parallel force multiplied by the displacement. So F parallel times delta X. The force was 25 newtons, the displacement 1.2 meters, and when we run the numbers on this, we get 30 newton meters or joules. In part B, we want to get the final angular velocity of the disk, and this is just a work energy theorem problem. The work that we put into it is reflected in the rotational kinetic energy of the disk. There was no initial rotational kinetic energy, so it's just the work that we put in is equal to the final kinetic energy, and that's given by 1/2 I omega squared. Now we are reminded in this problem that the moment of inertia of a disk is 1/2 mr squared. So we sub that in, and I'll go ahead and just pop numbers in right now, and then we'll solve for omega. So the work that we put in was 30 joules. Then I have a 1/2 times 1/2 or 1/4. The mass of the disk, 3.5 kilograms. The radius was 0.4 meters, just switching to SI units there. And we have to square that, and then we have an omega squared. So we divide 30 by the product of all these coefficients and then square root the result to solve for omega. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 14.6 radians per second. Next, we want to get the angular acceleration of the disk. And there's a subtle point that I want to highlight here. The force is constant that we're applying on this hub. That means the torque we're applying is constant, which in turn means the angular acceleration is constant. So to get the angular acceleration at any moment in time, all we have to do is look at the simple rate of change in the angular velocity. So delta omega divided by delta t. Well, the change in angular velocity is just the final minus initial, but the initial was zero. So I have 14.6 radians per second. That's divided by how long it took to get up to that speed, and that was given in the problem. That's 1.5 seconds. When I run the numbers on this, alpha comes out to 9.73 radians per second squared. Finally, we get to the somewhat unusual part D, where we're asked to compute the radius of the hub. This is something we normally would be given, but in this problem, we're actually finding it. So we have to think about why this would be possible. And it starts with the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law. So the net torque is equal to I alpha, the moment of inertia, times the angular acceleration. Well, we're able to compute the moment of inertia. We already computed the angular acceleration. And then I think about, well, how can I break that torque down into smaller pieces? That results from a force exerted through a lever arm, where the lever arm is actually the radius of the hub that the string is wrapped around. So here's the key to the problem. The torque we're exerting is given by the known force of 25 newtons multiplied by the lever arm, the radius of the hub. Our moment of inertia is 1/2 mr squared, where r is the radius of the disk. And then alpha is something we already computed. So now we can just go ahead and plug in the numbers and solve for that little r, the radius of the hub. F was 25 newtons, so I have 25r is equal to 1/2 times the mass of the disk, that was 3.5 kilograms, times its radius squared, 0.4 squared, times the angular acceleration alpha, which we computed was 9.73 radians per second squared. And when I run the numbers on this, I get that r is 0.109 meters, which might be nicer to express in centimeters as 10.9 centimeters. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.